Welcome, myself Mr. Vishal Angire, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics and Telecommunication, Walchand Institute of Technology. Today we'll study Superposition Theorem, which is to be used to solve circuit and network related problems. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, student will be able to apply Superposition Theorem to find unknown voltage or current through the circuit element. Before studying Superposition Theorem, you should recall Kirchhoff's voltage law, Kirchhoff's current law, series and parallel combination of passive circuit elements, voltage division, current division, star and delta connection, and source transformation. Introduction to Superposition Theorem. So, when two or more sources are present in a network and not connected in series or parallel, Superposition Theorem is very much useful to find circuit parameters like voltage or current. Now we'll see statement of Superposition Theorem. If a number of voltage or current sources are acting simultaneously in a linear network, the resultant current in any branch is the algebraic sum of the currents that would be produced in it when each source acting alone replacing all other independent sources by their internal resistances. So basically, in Superposition Theorem, if we want to find out current through a circuit element, the must condition is sources must be two or more than two, and that time we have to analyze effect of each source individually and remaining sources are to be deactivated. So while deactivating the remaining sources, if it is voltage source, we have to replace the voltage source by its internal resistance, and if it is current source, we have to delete the current source and then we have to analyze the effect. Now we'll see explanation of Superposition Theorem. So consider the simple DC circuit as shown in this figure, and the problem statement is we have to find out current IL flowing through the resistor of 1 kilo ohm, and for this we have to use Superposition Theorem. So while applying superposition to this particular problem, we have to deactivate one voltage source which is of 5 volt, and we have to analyze effect of 10 volt voltage source. And while analyzing the effect of 10 volt voltage source, we have to consider current flowing through resistor of 1 kilo ohm as a IL1, and total current is to be represented by I. So to find out total current I, we have to use the formula that I is equal to V upon R. V is total voltage and R is total resistance. So total resistance is resistance of 2.2 kilo ohm in series with the parallel combination of 1 kilo ohm resistor and 330 ohm resistor. So current I, total current I, is 4.08 milliampere. Next, we have to find out current IL1 flowing through the resistor of 1 kilo ohm. For this we have to use current division rule. So formula is IL1 is equal to total current multiplied by resistance of 330 ohm upon 1k plus 330 ohm. So here current IL1 is 1.01 milliampere. So this is the current IL1 flowing through resistor of 1 kilo ohm when we are analyzing the effect of 10 volt voltage source. Next, now we have to consider the effect of voltage source 5 volt. So deactivate the voltage source of 10 volt by replacing it through its internal resistance, means we have to short circuit the branch. Here again we have to consider total current I flowing through the circuit, and current flowing through the resistor of 1 kilo ohm is to be represented by IL2. Now first we will find total current I, which is flowing through the circuit. So again use formula of I is equal to V upon R, I total current, V total voltage, and R total resistance. So here current I is equal to 5 volt, that is total voltage, upon total resistance. So total resistance is resistance of 330 ohm in series with the parallel combination of 2.2 kilo ohm resistance with 1 kilo ohm resistance. So total current I in this case is 4.91 milliampere. Now we have to find out current flowing through the resistor of 1 kilo ohm, which is to be represented by IL2. So here also, to find out current IL2, we have to use current division rule. So formula is IL2 is equal to total current I into resistor of 2.2 kilo ohm in numerator and in denominator addition of the resistances, that is 2.2 kilo ohm and 1 kilo ohm. So current IL2 flowing through the resistor of 1 kilo ohm, when we are analyzing the effect of 5 volt voltage source, becomes 3.37 milliampere. So now we got two currents, that is current IL1 when we are analyzing the effect of 10 volt voltage source and we have deactivated the voltage source of 5 volt, and current IL2 when we are analyzing the effect of voltage source 5 volt, that time we have deactivated the voltage source of 10 volt. Now the total current IL flowing through the resistor of 1 kilo ohm is algebraic sum of currents IL1 and IL2 when individual sources are acting alone and remaining sources are to be replaced by their internal resistances. So as per superposition theorem, total current IL is equal to IL1 plus IL2. So it is 1.01 milliampere plus 3.37 milliampere. So current IL flowing through resistor of 1 kilo ohm becomes 4.38 milliampere. So if you want, you can tally the current IL flowing through resistor of 1 kilo ohm by using another method, means conventional network solving method, and you can verify either the current is same or not. While preparing this video lecture, I have referred circuit theorem analysis and synthesis book by A. Chakravarti, 6 revised edition. Thank you.